Hello, hello, I'm Mrs. Samuels again. I'm here in baby Miles' bedroom. We did whales for his theme, for everyone wondering. So today, this video is gonna be about the top 8 things that I wish my students would know about surviving middle school. So I'm gonna go in backwards order. So I'm gonna start with my least amount of things, the last thing. I picked 8. Because I tried to think of everything and 8 came up to it, and 8 is my favorite number, so it worked out perfectly. Okay, number 8. The friends you have at the beginning of the year most likely won't be the friends you have at the end, and that's okay. You're changing and they are changing, and sometimes people change apart from each other, and that's okay. And please don't get upset about that. It's okay. Number 7. Okay, these are style things that I've noticed. Again, I've been a middle school teacher now. This is my 7th, 8th year in the middle school, and I've noticed a few things over the years. Boys, literally, it seems like the only thing that matters are your shoes. So as long as you have some nice shoes, some Nikes, you're good to go. It doesn't matter what else you are wearing. Put some Nikes on and you can be fine. Now girls, this is very interesting, and please, please, please believe me. I have seen some girls with some insane outfits. Some of my students come to school in outfits and with hairstyles and makeup and everything that I wouldn't even go to bed in. That's how insane these girls come to school. But nobody cares. And you know what? They are rocking it. And you know why? They have confidence. And they act like they don't care. That is the key. If you act like you don't care in middle school, nobody else will. It's amazing. So girls, rock that confidence. Boys, get the shoes, rock the confidence with everything else. And if you have confidence, not only will the girls not care what the girls are wearing, but then boys won't care what you're wearing either. And same thing for the boys. So have that confidence and you're all set on your outfit. And maybe this is just because I'm at a uniform school, but literally I've had girls come to like half their hair up here, half down here. I mean, just rock the confidence. Okay, number 6. This is another hygiene thing. You're in middle school, you're bound to get some acne at some point in time. And I've found that it's very interesting that my students wear Band-Aids on their faces. Not in my classroom, because I don't allow that. But what I've noticed is I've taken that trick at home. And at night, I sleep with a Band-Aid on my face over whatever I got going on, but I put toothpaste underneath the Band-Aid, and the toothpaste will dry out whatever is underneath your Band-Aid. So if you have a zit or something, put a piece of dab some toothpaste, put a Band-Aid over it, and wake up in the morning and it'll go away. Don't pick at it, it'll dry it out. It's so cool. So that's my tip number 6 to survive middle school. Number 5. Do your homework. Now, you're there to learn. I do know that it's social, but you really are there to learn. So with doing your homework, don't just do what the teacher tells you to do. You need to also study. You're not going to memorize all of these terms within the hour or so that you're with the teacher. There's just no way, because we don't have enough time to teach you all of that stuff over and over and over again, the repetition that you need, because we only have you for so much. So you need to study on your own. You just have to get used to it, unfortunately. Just suck it up, buttercup, and do it. It's very easy. Ask for help, too, if you need help studying. If you don't know how to study, ask your teacher. Obviously, we know what we're doing. We got there. We studied. So ask for some help. It's okay to ask for help. All right, number 4. Oh my gosh, this is another, again, it's a hygiene thing, but it's middle school. I need you to shower every day. Every day. And here's why. When you go to grandma's house or your cousin's house, there's a smell there. Their house has a certain smell. And guess what? They don't know what their house smells like. Just like you don't know what your house smells like. You need to know that your body is secreting an odor. It'll either be good or it'll either be bad. Unfortunately, you don't know what you smell like because you're used to your smell. Just like grandma doesn't know what her house smells like because she lives there. That's what she smells all the time. So you need to shower every day. Now, if you don't think you smell, but you're not showering, let me tell you, you're smelling, okay? I'm just letting you know, you're smelling, all right? Now, boys, when you go in the shower, I have four boys at home. I know this works. You need to actually use soap. You actually have to physically use soap. You need to use soap. And girls, you need to wash your hair every so many days. I rock the shower cap, okay? But I also take it off every once in a while and I actually wash my hair. You need to wash your hair, girls, because even your hair will start to smell. Even though the rest of you are clean, your hair will start to smell. Tips, please brush soap, okay? All right, number three. Find someone who is going to get on your case about your grades. Either your parents or your grandma or your brother or sister or somebody in college, somebody that you know, even a teacher. Find somebody that is going to get after you and don't hide your grades from them. That's the accountability piece that students need all the time. I still need that now when I go back to college. I need to find somebody who's going to keep me in check. You also need to find that same person, and then again, don't hide it from them. It's okay if you are messing up and you have a D, but it's not okay to not ask for help. That's when the issue is. You need to get the help, and you need to have somebody care about your grades. Actually care, that will get on your butt. Number two, this is very important. I need middle schoolers. My second tip is to say no. You need to learn to say no. Now, this is from basic things. If you know somebody's not going to give you a pencil back, say no. It's okay. Learn to say no. You don't have to explain yourself. If you have 20 pencils, but you know they're going to steal your pencil, say no. It's okay. Number one, and Park was about to walk in. Let's watch. See you. All right, the number one tip that I wish students knew about going to middle school is that you need to find what makes you you and rock it. So if that means that you are the nerd, or you like to read, or you like to be creative with your outfit or your hair or your makeup, or you like to rock random nail polish, whatever you feel comfortable with, don't let anybody else tell you that you're doing it wrong, and don't let anybody else in the entire world ever make you feel bad for something that you like to do. If you like it, you rock it every single day.
Like me playing Pokemon.
Like him playing Pokemon. If he likes playing Pokemon, he rocks it. And if somebody says something to him about it, he better not care, right? You can't care.
Yeah. I don't care.
You can't care. Who cares? Life is too short for that. That's my number one tip, is to find you and rock it. And again, those friends probably won't be with you at the end, and that's okay. All right? So these are my eight tips to survive middle school. I hope you guys find them useful, a little bit silly with the Band-Aid and the toothpaste.
What Band-Aid and toothpaste?
Well, you have to watch my YouTube video. All right, guys. I'll see you guys in a few days. Thank you guys for checking in. Make sure you get more people to subscribe. All right. Bye, guys.